BL Santoshji as part of the launch of another organization in Bangalore, that if at all there is, let's say, a state which can legitimately claim to host the intellectual capital, at least currently, I'd say that space is jointly shared by Bangalore and Mysore. I said this before. And since the statement is already on record, rest assured this is not a statement made for public consumption. So, I've said this on that occasion as well, that this is perhaps one of the few states that has managed to strike a decent balance between three different strains of flow, let's say waves of human thought. One is the need to celebrate what belongs to you and what is perhaps your closest identity, which is the identity as a Kannadiga. The second is keeping an open mind to ideas that come from outside. And therefore, there is a degree of cosmopolitanism that pervades Karnataka as a state and certainly these two cities. And three, that it is possible to strike a fantastic balance between the past and the present without the past necessarily being relegated to, let's say, the status of a relic in a museum, is something that the state brilliantly demonstrates. And I can't think of a better city than, in fact, Mysore to showcase this particular aspect. Because every time you pass through this particular city, you wonder at the spirit of the city to keep its architecture alive, its buildings alive, and to somehow, let's say, stem the rapid movement of so-called development in such a way that it submerges whatever is native to this particular city, the spirit and culture of this particular city. So kudos to the spirit of Mysore and the people of Mysore for having done what you have. I wish there were more cities.